हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू सेव बाउंड्री गेम वीडियो ट्यूटोरियल्स सीरीज। इन द प्रीवियस वीडियो ट्यूटोरियल वी हैव रिटन कोड फॉर गेम लूप। आई क्लिक ऑन सेकंड फ्रेम ऑफ एक्शंस अंडरस्कोर लेयर, गो टू विंडो मेन्यू, से एक्शंस। यू कैन सी दैट एक्शंस विंडो इज लॉन्च्ड। वी हैव टू फंक्शंस, इनिट फंक्शन एंड अपडेट फंक्शन। We know that init function is executed only once in the beginning of the gameplay, whereas update function is executed continuously 30 times per second. We know that we use init function to initialize variables, to set up initial status of game objects, to add event listeners, etc., etc. Whereas we use update function to perform any operations continuously, guys. Let me comment this line of code. I don't want to execute that line of code. I want to comment this line of also. I say Control S to save and close it. What I want in this video tutorial is, I want to move this ball in X axis. I want to move the ball horizontally, guys. I right click on it, say convert to symbol. I name it ball underscore MC. Symbol type, I select movie clip, registration point top left corner, say OK. Then I give the instance name ball underscore MC, all characters in lowercase. We can access this ball inside action script using this instance name, guys. And you can see ball underscore MC, x is 0, y is 0. Ball x is 0, y is 0, guys. Before we proceed and move this ball in the x axis, first we understand the coordinate system of the stage. At the top left corner of the stage, we have the origin, guys, where x is 0, y is 0. In this place, we have x value 0, y value 0. Positive x axis is towards right and negative x axis is towards left. Positive x axis is towards right, negative x axis is towards left. Positive y axis is downward and negative y-axis is upward. This is the most important point to remember. Positive y-axis is downward, negative y-axis is upward, guys. So that is the coordinate system of the stage. You must and should understand. Let me go to flash. I want to move this ball towards right. So how do I move the ball towards right? I have to change the x position. If I increase the x position, you see, ball starts moving towards right. You can see the x position in this place, 37, 58, 121, 192. I'm changing the x position here. So ball is moving towards right, you can see that. Let me set the x position back to 0. So how do I change this x position? Let me go to second frame of the actions underscore layer. Go to window menu, say actions. I'm going to create one variable. I say var velocity in x of type number semicolon, and then I set the velocity in x equals to 10 initially. This velocity x we are going to add to the ball x position continuously, guys. So here inside the update function, I say ball underscore mc dot x should be equal to ball underscore mc dot x plus velocity in x. We are continuously adding velocity in x, that is 10, to ball x and setting the new value to the x of the ball, guys. So what this code actually does? What is the meaning of this line of code? New x position of the ball should be equal to current x position of the ball plus velocity in x. We know that the update is going to call 30 times per second, so this line of code gets executed 30 times per second. First time when the update is called, ball x will be 0. At present, the ball x is 0, right? Velocity x is 10. 0 plus 10 will be 10. 10 is going to become the new x position of the ball. So what happens? Ball moves towards right 10 pixels. On the next update call, ball x position will be 10. Velocity x is 10. 10 plus 10 will be 20. 20 is going to become the new x position of the ball. So ball moves towards right 20 pixels. On the next update call, ball x position is 20, 20 plus 10 will be 30, new x position of the ball will be 30. So ball moves towards right 30 pixels. Like that, on every update call, ball moves towards right 10 pixels, guys. I say Control S to save, close it, I hit Control Enter, I click on the play button, you see that the ball is moving towards right. I close it, hit Control Enter, I click on the play button, you see that the ball is moving towards right. So what is happening? On every update call, ball is moving towards right 10 pixels. So that is how we move the ball in x-axis. Let me select the ball and I set its x position to 580. Now the ball is on the top right corner. Now I want to move this ball towards left. For that, what I do, I go to second frame of the actions underscore layer, go to window menu, say actions. I set the velocity in x this time minus 10. Because we want to move the ball towards left, its x position should get reduced. At present, it is at 580. It should become 570, 560, 550, 540, 530, 520, 510. So like that, the ball x position should get reduced. So I'm setting here velocity x minus 10. At present, it is at 580. 580 minus 10 will be 570. So the x position of the ball will be 570. On the next update call, it will be 560. On the next update call, it will be 550. Like that, the ball x position changes and ball starts moving towards left. I say Control S to save, close it, I hit Control Enter, I click on the play button, you see that the ball is moving towards left. I close it, I hit Control Enter, I click on the play button, you can see that the ball is moving towards left. So, if I have to move the ball towards left, I set the velocity x minus in negative. If I have to move the ball towards right, I set the velocity x positive, guys. I go to window menu, say actions. Let me set the velocity x back to positive 10. If you want, you can give more velocity, right? Velocity x indicates just the speed in x axis, okay? I say Control S to save, close it. Let me select the ball, set its x position to 0, hit enter. I say Control Enter, click on the play button, the ball moves towards right. So that is how we move the ball in x axis. I select the second frame of the actions underscore layer, go to window menu, say actions. I suggest you people to write this code and try to move the ball in x axis. I think for this video tutorial, this much is enough, friends. In the upcoming video tutorials, we are going to discuss more about Save Boundary Game. If you like this video, hit the like button and share with your friends so that everyone will get benefited. For more benefits and be up to date, do not forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel. Keep learning, keep coding, keep sharing. Thank you guys, thank you very much. See you in the next tutorial.